still had 4 days to go on my Kruger Park trip. With all the sand roads closed south of the Olifants River, there was probably no other options but to do what I was about to do. I managed to change a couple of nights from Satara to Punda Maria Rest Camp. Setting off at 5 o'clock in the morning, I knew this was going to be one way long drive, and I knew that there was going to be rain ahead. The tar road leaving Satara was quite busy. Obviously, with all the sand roads being closed, the only roads that could be taken was the tar road north, south, east and west of Satara. Of course, on this morning, every single person from Satara was heading north the same direction as me. When I arrived at the Olifants River, it was now full and flat. After a short sightseeing stop at the lookout point, it was time to head on. The birding was turning out to be quite spectacular. Every single river that I crossed, every stream, every little causeway, seemed to have water in it. This was not unsurprising considering the amount of rain that had fallen over the previous couple of days. After a peaceful stop at the big dam on the S50, it was time to move on. I was still only halfway from my destination, and time was starting to move on. Just around Shingwedzi were the first elephants I'd seen the entire trip. 6 days in the park, and these were the first elephants that I had seen. I didn't want to be the one to say it, but I think these elephants were scared of a bit of water. A few kilometers north of Shingwedzi, I stopped on a bridge overlooking a river. I noticed a couple of bee eaters splashing in the river, drinking or catching something out of the water. Another vehicle, which was also stopped on the bridge, approached me to tell me that these were in fact not white-fronted bee eaters that were splashing in the river, but white-throated bee eaters. Now for the birders of you out there, there is nothing more exciting than when you have to turn to the back of your bird book to find a bird that shouldn't actually be in an area that you're currently sitting in. After sitting for a while, they eventually sat in a tree where I was able to take a couple of pictures and a few videos. It's amazing how something as innocuous as a bee eater can become the highlight of your trip. The next 2 days were spent traversing between Punda Maria and Shingwedzi. Shingwedzi River running through red rocks was flowing strongly and is always quite a sight to see. The north definitely doesn't disappoint. I sat and had my lunch on the Shingwedzi bridge, watching some impala drinking and feeding from the embankments on the side of the river. It really had been a peaceful couple of days, with some really excellent sightings as well. I had finished everything I needed to do around Shingwedzi, so I decided the following day was to head up to Pafuri. First though, there would be quite a few surprises on the way back to camp. There had been intermittent rain the whole day. However, when I got back to camp, I could see the extent of how much rain had actually happened in Punda Maria camp. Nothing like camping with a river running through your tent. After a quick stop at the hide, I would go out for an afternoon drive. These guinea fowl looked pretty unperturbed by me trying to get water out of my tent. The afternoon drive would provide another lifer for me, a European honey buzzard. At the time though, this bird did not want to identify itself. Ideas on identification split, 50-50. Later on it was decided, general consensus was that this was the European honey buzzard. Less than a kilometre from the gate at Punda Maria camp was a single wild dog standing in the road. No longer than 30 seconds and it was gone. Thanks for watching. Please look out for the next trip where we head off to Pafuri.